Alright, so welcome back, students. We are now down to the last part of this topic, which is the topic 3, which is all about the historical development of satellite geodesy and its application. So let's start the historical accounts of satellite geodesy. The proper development of satellite geodesy started with the launch of the first artificial satellite. Tawag niya is Sputnik 1. So it is launched last October 4, 1957. So maoni ang iyahang picture no sa Sputnik 1. And in 1802, after the launching of the Sputnik 1, the next historical accounts is in 1802. The Laplace used lunar nodal motion precision to determine the flattening of the Earth. So from the Laplace, ang na-determine na Earth flattening is 1 over 303. But according to the flattening of this famous person, maupod niya ang ilang nakuha nga flattening, which is dool lang, no? Dool lang sa nakuha nga flattening, no? Using the lunar nodal motion or precession. So, from Hansen, no, in 1864, na nakuha nga 1 over 296, and si Hilmert, 1 over 297.8, and si Hill, flattening is equal to 1 over 297.2, which is dool-dool lang siya sa pamaagi sa lunar nodal motion precision. Alright, so talking about precision, Earth is not a perfect homogeneous sphere, so we all know that. Its rotation is affected likewise by gravitational actions of the bodies in the solar system. So, we all know nga dili man jud perfect na sphere no si Earth. So, naa jud pud siya external no nga attraction between the celestial bodies around the solar system. So, when we say precession, it is a change in the orientation of rotational axis of a rotating body. So, again, precession is the change of orientation of rotational axis. So, ang pasabot na niya class, kung si ang orientation karon sa axis sa Earth, no, is paana. So, kung magpaingana siya ang forma, ang tuyo sa Earth is paana po, no? So, and time pass by, so ma-change ang iyang orientation axis, mahim na siyang inani. Maligtad ang iyang rotational axis, then ana na ang iyang tuyo, no? Precision. So later on, ito lang ang tanawag kung ano sa'yo kasamutan niya. In an appropriate reference frame, it can be defined as a change in the first Euler angle, whereas the third Euler angle defines the rotation itself. So yan niya ang pasabot na ako. No? So, considering ang Earth's Earth's axis, no, karon Earth's rotational axis is na diri since na diri si Polaris. So pasabot paana ang iyang tuyok, no. So time passes by, mag-change ang iyang North Star, no. And ang next daw na ang pag-abot siya sa separate sa opposite niya nga axis, Earth's rotational axis is ang iyang ng North Star is niya sa Polaris, si Vega na. So that's around 26 billion years, no. So 26 billion years from now, so dili na si Polaris ang ato ang North Star, si Vega na. So around, mali pala, 26,000 years pala. So hindi pala billion years. So 26,000 years na. Precession, change in orbital na rotational axis niya, no? Change ang iyang rotational axis. That's precession. So napo tayo gitawag nga nutation, no? So nutation pod are due primarily in the lunisolar attractions, no? And hence it can be modeled on the basis of geophysical model of the Earth and its motion in space relative to Sun and the Moon. Or in other term, it is a rocking, swaying, or nodding motion of the axis of rotation, no? And of largely axially symmetric objects such as a gyroscope, planet, or bullet in flight as an intended behavior of mechanism. So, pasabot po sa nutation, samtang nag-change na siya og orbital, nag-change na siya og rotational axis. So, naapoy mahitabo nga rocking and swaying or nodding, no, motion sa samtang nagtuyok siya. So, yung example niya ay si Nani. So, di ba, pag mo change na diri apadulong, so that's precision, no? Kung mag-change yung orbital orbital axis, no? Kung tayo naadri ang karon ng orbital axis, so due time, padulong dito, paana na ang iyahang orbit. So, samtang po subay siya sa path sa precision, na po'y rocking and swaying, no? Or tawagan ng nodding. So, na ay motion, no? Nga, ingani po ng iyahang path, kaning paana. Tapos, wave po ng forma, no? So, that's mutation. Ayan siya, no? Precision, change in orbital axis, and si mutation, samtang nag-agi siya sa precision na ay swaying or rocking, no? Nga, motion. So, that's mutation. So, again, when we say precession, it is the change in orientation of the rotational axis with respect to our reference plane. And talking about moon, the orbit of the moon undergoes two important types of precessional motion. So, natagitawag na apsidal and nodal. So, again, dili lang si Earth ang maka-encounter precession but also moon. First is the apsidal. So, apsidal, in celestial mechanics, apsidal precession or orbital precession. No? Pag may tag apsidal, another term niya is si orbital. Orbital precession or the change of the orbit. No? Muna siyang pasabot. No? It's the precision of the rotation of the orbit of the celestial body. No? Kung mawala yung celestial body like Earth, no? With respect to Sun, mag-change ang iyahang orbit. And more precisely, it is the gradual rotation of the line joining the upsides of the orbit, which are the points of closest and farthest approach. So in this case, pag moingon kay tag perihelion, so that is a pag moingon tag helion, no, kay sun man jud na, kay from the word itself, from the Greek word, pag moingon tag helion, sun jud na siya ang pasabot. No, so pag mayon tag perihelion, it is a celestial object, no, that the celestial object is closest with respect to the sun, no, perihelion. So pag ingani ang case, no, sa tanaw nato diri sa figure, no, ang perihelion ani niya nga object, which is the Earth, is kaning mas duol siya sa sun, which is diri ang apart, no, diri ang apart. So muna siya si perihelion. And pag moingon po ta class of farthest, no, farthest point with of the celestial object with respect to sun, ang tawag po dala niya is aphelion, no, aphelion, no, aphelion. In this case or this illustration, ang aphelion niya is naadriya opposite sa perihelion. So kani diriya, no, diriya ang aphelion, pinaka farthest, no? Pero pag moingon po ta with respect to Earth, no, with respect to Earth, like for example, si Moon with respect to Earth, no, pag si Moon is closest to the Sun, closest to the Earth, rather, closest to the Earth, ang tawag na po siya is perigee, no, so perigee, kung sa Sun, perihelion, ang sa, with respect to the Earth is perigee, no, P-R-I-G-E-E, no, pero pag layo, ang tawag na po niya is apogee, no, apogee, A-P-O-G-E-E. So pag layo si Moon with respect to Earth, apogee, pag duol, perigee. So this is another illustration, no, of the apsidal motion or orbital precession. So na i-change sa iyahang orbit. And another one is the nodal precession. Nodal precession, it is a precession of the orbital plane of a satellite around the rotational axis of an astronomical body such as the Earth. Another one, atong otrohon, nodal precession is the precession of the orbital plane. Changes na po siya sa orbital plane of the satellite around the rotational axis. When we say, kumaoni si Moon, no? So, kung maupo niya ang rotational axis sa Earth, no? Mag-change pa ng iyahang rotational axis or iyahang orbital plane with respect to rotational axis sa astronomical body. So, kung si Earth mag-change ng iyahang or mag-change ng iyahang rotational axis, mag-change po ang orbital plane sa isa ka astronomical body such as moon, no? Moon with respect to Earth. So, that's nodal precession. So here are the more some significant events during the years, no? After the 1957 or October 4, 1957, which is the launch of the Sputnik 1. So after 1957, 1958, no? So na-calculate ang Earth's flattening from the satellite data, which is 1 over 298.3, no? From the launching of Sputnik 1, naka-derive din sila nga ang flattening di ay sa Earth is 1 over 298. Then, same year, 1958, is the launch of the Explorer 1. 1959, the third zonal harmonic, no? Which is ang iyahang theory is the pear-shaped daw ng Earth. No? And 1959, the same, is the theory of motion of the artificial satellites since kaya na may na-launch na satellite in the space. No? So, nandang inahitabo nga theory, no? Anong, the mechanics, what are the mechanics of the artificial satellites? So, of course, kaya kung naay ma-discoveryhan, so buhatan nila siya theory para mahimo na dayon siyang basihan, no? For other na gusto mo gamit at mga theory. Then, in 1960, the launch of Transit 1B, and same, in the same year, again, is the launch of the Echo 1. And another one, in 1960, na-create po ang theory of satellite orbits. And in 1962, si Ana 1B na po ang gilunch na. And lastly, in 1962 is the geodetic connection between the France and Algeria. So, naka-build na din sila connections. So, talking about Sputnik 1, no? The former Soviet Union, sila ang nag-launch ng sa Sputnik 1. Mauni siya ang first man-made satellite. Okay. Man-made, kaya ang nagbuhat is tao. No? Pag mayon po tao, natural, like moon, so natural naging siya nga, nanagin siya niya. Wala siya gi-alter sa mga tao. The satellite was the size of a basketball. No? Mura siya o basketball. And ang iyang kabugaton is about 180 pounds. And it traveled at 18,000 miles per hour. And 500 miles, it is, iyang kalayon po from the surface of the Earth is 500 miles above the Earth. So, Sputnik 1 stayed in the orbit for 3 months. So, 3 months lang siya. So, plunging to Earth on 4th of January 1958. So, ang operation lang yung Sputnik is about 3 months lang siya. And it orbited the Earth every 98 minutes. So, pasabot niya, makatuyok siya, no, sa Earth in 98 minutes. No? Okay, since ang iyahang speed at diba, is 18,000 miles per hour. So, siya. And it flies over the United States every 7 days. No? Every 7 times a day. So, they did not have a long wait, no? A month after of the launch of the Sputnik 1, again, si Soviet Union, nag-launch na po siya og Soviet, Sputnik 2, no? Mauni ang forma sa Sputnik 2. It is a half-ton satellite that carried a female dog. Ang tawag ato nga dog, ang pangalan ato nga dog is si Laika, no? Into orbit. So, gipaobanan nila og dog. This satellite was 6 times as heavy as the first. Mas bugat ni kaysa sa Sputnik 1. So, coming nga ang iyahang kabugaton is 1,100 pounds. And unfortunately, there was no plan in place, no, to get the dog safely back to the Earth, and it died in space. Of course, no. Kay iya pa matong gi-experimentuhan. So, wala pa po'y proper adto na unsaon ang pagpakaon, unsaon ang, di ba? So, wala nila to i-take into account. So, si dog namatay, or si Laika is namatay siya in space. So, mauni ang picture ni Laika. Ang dog nga ni Uban. Female dog. Uban sa Sputnik 2. Although Sputnik 1 shocked and irritated Americans, it did not frighten them. Assured by the president of the media, they believed na ang US satellite would have been first if Eisenhower had permitted the use of classified military rockets. And annoyed that the Soviets were the first into space. They were still considered that the US technology was far ahead of that of the USSR. So, mas una magi si Soviet. So, again, na-irritate or natandog ang pride sa mga Americans na dapat sila jud. Dapat mo. Pero, naman dyan technology nga makapakuan sa ilaha nga advanced kung baga no. So, here it comes nga si Soviet Union anak nga. The Explorer 1. So, okay, tungod kay irritated kayo ang Americans na dapat kami dyan ang una nga mo launch of satellites. So, here it comes, si Explorer 1. Money ang first satellite sa United States. It was launched as part of the participation of the International Geophysical Year. It was launched last January 31, 1958. So, that was pila ka months after October, November, December. 3 months, no? 3 months after the launch of the Sputnik 1. At the Cape Canaveral Missile Annex in Florida. It was the first spacecraft to detect the Van Allen radiation belt. And it returning the returning data until its batteries were exhausted after near 4 months. So 4 months open siya. So nahutan power ang batteries. And it remained in the orbit until 1970. Dugay, di ba? 1950 to 1970. Di na siya functional during that time. So 4 months na siya functional, then pila ka years, di ba? Dito na siya pumunta sa space. And it has been followed by more than 90 scientific spacecraft in the Explorer series after the Explorer 1. So mauni ang picture ni Explorer 1. And the proper development again is it came from the Sputnik 1 na launching, which is October 4, 1957. So na yun is na-calculate ang Earth flattening using this person, si Hansen, Helmut, and si Hill, using Laplace or Lunar Nodal Motion. So there are phases of development of satellite geodesy. So it is started from 1958 to around 1970. It is the development of basic methods of satellite observation and for the computation and analysis of satellite orbits. So since kay nag-discover pa man sila diri, experimental pa kumbaga. So basic methods lang and satellite observation lang ang ilahang na ilaha pang na develop for these phases. Then second phase is the 1970 to around 1980. These are the phase of the scientific projects. Na increase na ang accuracy of observation and made possible for the measurement of geodynamical phenomena such as earth motion, polar motion, and crustal deformation. So nagka-high-tech na sila. Next phase is the 1980 to 1990. So the phase of the operational use of satellite techniques such as in geodesy, geodynamics, and in surveying. So there na ni sunod si surveying, no, atong profession. And the GPS resulted in completely new perspectives in surveying and mapping. So na-incorporate na si GPS technology in the surveying and mapping. And of course, na-increase pa ang observation accuracy. Next is in 1990 to around 2000. This phase is for the international and national permanent services. So continuation for the phase of 1990 to around 2000 is the formation of the International Earth Rotation Services or IERS. So this services provides a highly accurate earth orientation parameters with high temporal resolution. So, ang temporal resolution is the visiting time of the satellites. Such as, for example, sa Landsat, so 16 days ang iyang temporal resolution. So, every 16 days, na kayo makuha nga data from that specific nga lugar, like sa Philippines. Next is again the creation of International Celestial Reference Frame or ICRF. So this frame, no, reference frames are based on the interferometric radio observations. Next is the International Terrestrial Reference Frame or ITRF. So it is based on different space techniques using the satellites. So continuation is the International GPS Service or IGS. It is the main source of precise GPS object orbits, no? As well as the four coordinates and observations from a global set of more than 300 permanently observing reference stations. Then, 2000 onwards, the next phase is the launch of the dedicated gravity fields probe like CHAMP, GRACE, GOCE for the determination of a highly resolution terrestrial gravity field. And in this phase also is for the further establishment of permanent arrays of disaster prevention and environmental monitoring. So hangtod karon, muna ni siya ang development, no? Satellite geodesy. Magamit na siya sa disaster prevention like weather forecasting, no? Environmental monitoring, impact assessment, and many more. Next is from the another development from the 2000 onwards is the establishment of the next generation global navigation satellite system or the GNSS. So from this one, from these years pala, no, ang launching niya sa mga GPS Block 2R and GPS Block 2F. So mo ni siya ang kaning mga block class is this is where kanang na, mga group sila of satellites, no, are under the ano the system of the GPS. And also naapoy mga new component sa GNSS like European Galileo. So pag may tag Galileo, si Europe ang tag-iyana nga sa satellite system. And in this phase also is the refinement in Earth's observation like high resolution radar sensors, no, for example ang interferometric SAR or kanang gitawag natong FSAR on various platforms, mas higher ng resolution. And the unification of different geodetic space techniques on mobile integrated geodetic geodynamic monitoring services. Pinanaday siya musulod sa ito ang cell phones, no? Mobile na. And challenging, no? This satellite na CHAMP, no? Or the challenging mini satellite payload, it was a German satellite, German ang nag-made, and it was launched on July 15, 2000 from Plesetsk, Russia, and was used for atmospheric and ionospheric researches. Also, ang iyahang gamit po, dili lang sa ionospheric and atmospheric, but as well as the geoscientific applications such as GPS radio occultation. And it was a joint mission, no, of the NASA and the German Aerospace Center na itawag nga twin satellites. No, si twin satellites is kaning itawag nga si GRACE or Gravity Recovery and Climate Experiment or si GRACE. It is a twin satellite used to measure the gravity field of the Earth. So output niya ani is ang geoid models, no, geoid models, si GRACE. So it is a joint mission, no, sa NASA and German Aerospace Center. And twin satellites took detailed measurements of Earth's gravity field and anomalies from its launch nga March 2002 until sa iyahang end sa iyahang mission last October 2017. So by measuring GRACE anomalies, gravity anomalies rather. So si GRACE showed how mass is distributed around the planet. And it how it varies over time. So, geoid, basically. And another, si kanin si gravity field and steady state ocean circulation explorer, or kanin si GOCE. It was launched on March 17, 2009 by European Space Agency. And ang mission niya is the, this mission pala was the first Earth Explorer mission in an orbit. So this sleek high-tech gravity satellite embodied the first in the design, and it is used for new technology in the space to map the Earth's gravity field in unprecedented detail. So much for the history accounts. Let's go back to the basic concepts of satellite geodesy. The importance of the artificial satellites in geodesy becomes evident from the following basic considerations. First consideration is the satellite can be used as high orbiting targets which are visible over a large distances. So these are the importance, no? And it must be considered in the concepts of satellite geodesy. So according to the first basic concept, satellites daw can be as high orbiting targets. Mas lagi magi siya, magdepende man siya sa distance from the Earth's surface, no? Natagi tawag na low Earth orbit, napuntay medium Earth orbit, and many more, no? Following the classical concept of Earth-bound trigonometric networks, the satellites may be regarded as fixed control points within a large scale or global three-dimensional networks. And if the satellites are observed simultaneously from different ground station, it is of no importance that the orbits of artificial satellites are governed by gravitational forces. So, muna siya ang kanang considerations. Next is the only the property that are targets at high altitudes is used. So, naman gitay ka ng kung kani nga specific altitudes or kintahay low Earth orbit siya nga satellite, so narapod siya considerations na narapod siya limit na nga ang iyaharap kong target nga pwede makuha is marapod to iyang mahatag na data or information. So this purely geometric consideration leads to geometrical method of satellite geodesy. Compared to classical surveying techniques, the main advantage of satellite methods is that they can bridge large distances. Of course, no? Sa una, mag-triangulate pa, no? Triangulation, magtukod patag mga towers para visible siya. But now, with the aid of satellites, no, it can connect, no? Bisan pa og large distances na siya. And thus, establish of geodetic ties between continents and islands. So, maunang, pwede na siya nato ma-relate, no? Ang different geodetic networks, no? Bisan pa og naa sa another isla, another country, by the use of satellites. For example, kanina, satellites can be used in high orbiting targets which are visible over a large distances. So, tahay kanina point diri ang country. Plus kanina point 2 is another country. And lastly, kanina pong point 3 is another country. And you are going to get the location, no? Or the position, termination of this new station. So, bisan paglagyo, no, miles and miles away na siya. By the using of satellite, we can get the information or the location of this new station. So, ang iyang concept class kaya nga ni, no, naipad ka satellites with different orbits, no? So, ang ilang pamaagi para makuha sila another information or location of this point, so nagamit sila intersection. So ang ilahang kintahay class, ang kani is na siya 500 kilometers ang iyahang altitude, so magbuffer siya 500 kilometers. Ang kani po, let's say 200 ni siya kaning green, so magbuffer po siya 200, kani is 100, kani po is 100, so magbuffer sila until nga kung ahatong point nga nag-abot sila, so moto murag mura dyan po siyang triangulation ang iyahang ang concept, pero through satellites. Number 2 is satellites can be considered to be a probe or sensor in a gravity field of Earth. So, di lang siya sa location determination, but of course, the determination of the gravity field of the Earth. So, mauna iyahang mga results. No? The orbital motion and the variation of the parameters describing the orbit are observed in the order to draw the conclusions about forces acting on the Earth. Of particular interest in the relation between the features and the terrestrial gravity field and the resulting deviation of true satellite orbit from the undisturbed Keplerian motion. Another is the essential value of the satellite is that is the moving body within the Earth's gravity field. And this view leads to the dynamical method of the satellite geodesy. So the main advantage of a satellite observation when compared to classical surveying is the results refer to the planet Earth as a whole, and they have a global character by nature. So marami kalainan niya sa classical satellite na method. Another is data gaps played a minor role. Among the first spectacular results were reasonably accurate value of the Earth's flattening. So by the use of the satellites and compared sa old na theories and old na methods, ang kaning ginatawag na itong data gaps or kaning differences between the values of the datas nga atong ma-acquired is minor na lang siya. It's because gamay na lang kayo ilang differences. For example, the Earth's flattening. So, based on the theory and calculations of the different scientists, mana sila nakuha ang flattening, but through the observation of the satellite, nakuha ang Earth's flattening, which is small na lang kayo ang differences. So, and the proof that the figure of the Earth is non-symmetrical with respect to equatorial planes. Ito siya. Another is, in dynamical satellite geodesy, orbital arcs of different lengths are considered, and when arc lengths between few minutes and up to several revolutions around the Earth are used, we speak of short arc techniques. Pagamay lang daw kuno ang few minutes up to the several revolutions. So ang tawag na niya ay short arc techniques, and the term for use for longer arcs around 30 days and more, ang pamaagi po na niya is long arc techniques. Ang pasabot na is ang iha sigurong dynamic or ang speed. So pagdugay, long arc techniques, and for short is short arc techniques. The orbit are described in suitable geocentric reference frames. So satellites can be considered a probe or a sensor in gravity field of the Earth. Through sensors, makakreate taog geoid. Alright, so let's go to the applications. Masaday, ahadin yung ma-apply si satellite geodesy. First application is the global geodesy. In global geodesy, it merely focuses on the general shape of the Earth's figure and gravity field. So, from the satellites or satellite geodesy concept, we can figure out the Earth's shape and also the gravity fields. And we can determine the dimensions of a mean Earth ellipsoid. Kung natay ellipse, makakuha din siya ang parameters. So for global geodesy, again, is the establishment of the global terrestrial reference plane. Okay, tungkol kay si satellite geodesy can do bisan pa og lagyo nga distances. So global na ang iyang coverage. So global po dang iyang ma-establish nga mga reference frames, no? Such as ITRF, no? Example ni. And satellite geodesy can have a detailed geoid as a reference surface on land, at sea, or for heights. And it can build connection between different existing geodetic datums, kay since again large naman ang pwede naman siya makadeal into large areas, then makakonnect din siya or nandiyan siya relationship between the geodetic datums of the countries. So pwede na to siya matransform into from other datum to another datum and so on and so forth. Then connection of national datums with the global geodetic datums. Mara dyan punta kung diyan kayo ganina. So for applications, the geoid is the shape of an imaginary global ocean detected in the gravity in the absence of tides and currents. Nagitawag na itong mean sea level. Pag mean sea level, the absence of high tides and low tides. By the way, class, pag makakreate taong mean sea level, dili siya ka na ganing tawagan na kanang dali lang, no? So the creation of the Minsi level is merely 19 years continuous observation of the tides at that specific location. So iminto siya, so manana siya ang Minsi level. And ang surface atong Minsi level is mukuhain siya sa geoid. Then ang geoid is murag i-extend lang din mo sa mga continents. So mo na siya ang surface sa geoid. So musaka siya pag ang landmass of that specific area is high dense. Musaka siya pero bumuubos pag low dense siya. So that's the geoid. An accurate model of the geoid is also important in surveying and geodesy. So satellite geodesy as a science, no, is maka create siya of accurate model of geoid, which is important in the surveying, no? Okay, since sa surveying diri ta magbase sa atong heights, no? And in geodesy as a whole, no? And for studying earth interior processes. So sa ka importante si satellite geodesy for the application of the crustal movement, no, or tectonic movement. So detect na ni geodesy ni satellite geodesy nga satellite geodesy nga science, no. Okay, ma-detect niya ang crustal movement. Kaya naman since maka create man siya og accurate na geoid, so ma determine pud niya ang changes sa land formations. No? Beside from that, no, ang coordinates mismo, no, coordinates sa location. And for geodetic control application, si satellite geodesy is ma-apply siya in geodetic control in establishment of geodetic control for national networks. So in fact, no, in DMC 2010-13, no, na dapat all geodetic controls must be observed in GPS technology. So satellite na ang gigamit. Pag may geodetic control, mao na siya ang mga tie points or the origin of the origin siya sa nganay locations like northings, eastings, and elevation. So mao na siya ang gamiton as the basis for all geodetic networks within the places. No, kanang para sa example BLLM1, no? Output na siya, geodetic control na siya. No, and kana nga mga location is mga first and second or higher accuracy na siya nga level of control, no. So mao nang kinahanglan siya og satellite or GPS technology. So next is from the geodetic control application, it's the installation of three-dimensional homogeneous networks. Next is analysis of improvement of existing terrestrial networks. So kung nanay mga daan ng mga muhon, no, or mga BLLMs, i-improve siya and analyze using GPS technologies, which is output siya sa satellite geodesy. Next is the establishment of geodetic connections between islands or with the mainland. From the main control, no, which is mga BLLM, padulong na dahil sa mga lower accuracy ng mga geodetic control networks such as kanang mga local control, no. Ng from the tie point, magbuhat ng another control mas dool sa location na imong i-survey. Next is densification of existing networks up to short interstation distances. Connections gihapon or networks of geodetic controls. For example, this one. This is the GNSS receivers, kani mga satellites. And this one is the GPS receiver. So from the satellites, muhatag sa diriya og data sa GNSS receiver, as well as muhatag po sa diriya og data sa GPS receiver, no? So ang data is from this GNSS receiver or GPS receiver, pwede niya ma-transfer to another GPS receiver, and output ana niya class is kani, for example, no, control, no, control station, benchmark, no, for geoids, no, from the geoid na model or for heights, no, establishment. So yan na lang siya, no? Connections between stations, no, station to station using the satellites. Another one, no, at a reference station, ikaw nga gusto ka mo kuha og topography, or for example topography of the land, so naa kay gitawag nga reference station. So si satellite mohatag og data sa kaning receiver, tapos same pod mohatag pod siya og data sa reference station, i-correct din para ang kaning makuha nga data sa user is accurate. So system siya, network actually siya nga mohatag siya og satellite to GNSS receiver, satellite to reference station, din sa reference station mo-transmit og data padulong sa kaninga user. I-correct, kibali, no? Kaya kung mas accurate man ang mahatag sa reference station, kaya syempre, with all the errors man, like for example, naglihok ka or nag, nasa man siya ka na, nakatilt ba yung mohang pole, no? So, mohatag siya data, pero mohatag siya data sa imo directly, but mohatag po siya data sa reference station para mahatagan niya og correction, no? Correction data para gikan ating reference station, ang mahatag ana niya sa imo is ang corrected na nga data, no? For example, kami sa GNSS receivers. Like for example, magkuhag topography na i-base station or antenna pala na siya. This is the base station, tapos na antenna. So, from that base station, kay since fixed man siya, siya na po lang mo-transmit of data pagdulong sa rover. Panang i-bit-bit nila. Next application is the geodynamics, no? Which has the control points, no? Establishment of control points for crustal motion. So, kung di ganyan na, di ba? Katong mga movement sa tectonics, no? Permanent arrays for three-dimensional control in active areas, polar motion, Earth's rotation, and solid Earth times. In applied and plane geodesy, so application po ni satellite geodesy is the detailed plane surveying. For example, land registration, no? Urban and rural surveying. Muna man yung mga lower na okay, plane surveying naman siya. Geographic information system, of course, to the location of the important features na imuhang gusto istadihan. No? And town planning, boundary demarcation, installation of special networks for control of engineering tasks. So, muna kung giing ano, magbuhat ka og local control nimo from the tie point of geodetic control. Terrestrial control points in photogrammetry and remote sensing. Of course, kanang mag duka o kanang photogrammetry quirks, no, na imuhang i-process. So need siya o geodetic control network, no, na visible sa ground. And ang pagkuhaan na nga point is determined by the satellites through satellite geodesy na science. The position and orientation of airborne sensors like photogrammetry cameras, no, labi na karoon ka ng mga drones, no, equipped na sila with GNSS technology. So, kung nababantayan ninyo kung kisa na nakatry sa inyo sa photogrammetry, no, nga i-link lang nimo siya, no, sa satellites or GPS, then pag-fly anan niya class, then muhata din na siya kibali, imo man siyang giinputan og flight plan. So, subayon to niya nga flight plan, okay? Since ang imuha pong cellphone na gigamit, which is Android, so naman to siya locations, right? Ang imuhang gi-digitize nga area, imong gibutangan og flight plan is na naman to yung mga location, so mo to yung sundon. So it came out nga, if ever mahuman na siya o tanan og capture sa yung flight plan, mubalik siya sa kung ahanin mo siya gi-palupad, kinaman siya yung location. So that's how the satellite geodesy na knowledge is magamit siya for the photogrammetry cameras or airborne sensors. Next is control for position information in different accuracy levels, such as in forestry, agriculture, archaeology, expedition, cartography, and etc. No? For example, kanino? Output ni siya sa airborne sensors, no? Or aerial cameras. So, ang kanyang mga punuan puntlas is na siya exact location. Naka-georef na siya kung mo unsay location sa surface sa Earth, mapuda yung location anak na adiriya. Labi na ibutan nimo sa GIS, i-identify ni mo kung unsay ihang location, same na sila. This is for urban planning plus. Oh. So, based from the satellite data, makakuha ka og important features that will ngay mong pwede gamiton, no? Sa urban planning, land classification mapping, no? And so on and so forth. So, magladerize na dahil na siya. No? Kung unsa ang usual na ginabuhat karon sa mga geodetic engineers or mga GIS analysts, is it came from the output of the satellite geodesy. So, this is for aerial cameras. No? Ang output ni siya, three-dimensional photogrammetry by the use of aerial photographs. So, kanimo ni siya ang mga na-capture niya sa taas. No? Pag imo na siyang i-process, i-ortho-rectified, mauni ang forma. So, muna na natin itawag na ortho-photos. It's because it is ortho-rectified. And pag muna siya ortho-rectified, na siya yung mga coordinates na, no? Naka-georef na siya. And next application is for navigation and marine geodesy. And satellite geodesy technology or designs is na siya relationship in determining the precise navigation of land, sea, and air vehicles, no? Such as kanang mga barko. No? Para dili sila mawala, no? Ang ilahang path nga agihan is determined na siya daan. So musubay na lang dahil na si captain atong barko sa katong path nga ilahang gibuhatan para makaabot gid sila sa ilang destination. No, kay kung wala sila kay sa una kay they are using sextant man, no, to determine nga okay, we are now in the longitude blah blah blah, latitude blah blah blah. So karon di na sila mo gamit atong sextant. So they are using the satellite technology to determine the location kung ana sila karon, no? And through the help also of the path na ilahang agihan, which is determined na daan, sumunod lang to ilang sundon. And for air vehicles such as airplanes, no, they are also using satellite data, no, para matrack nila ang location sa isa ka airplane, no. Na makabantay mo klas na kanang pag nakasakay na mo og airplane or kung sino nakasakay sa new airplane, ay makabantay mo sahay nga niabot naman ni, for example, matung Manila. So, makatry mo ang air traffic, anong itawag mo ng air traffic. No? Na, makabantay mo nga, naabot naman tanan ni Manila, nga nung dili pa man siya mo landing. No? It's because, naman sila, equipment sila GNSS technology, GNSS, or no, satellite technology class na matrack nila, no, nga pasabot. Okay, di sa kong mo landing, no? Kay mo ingon tong ang ilahang monitor dito sa ground, sa airport na, okay, ayos sa landing kay sa imong nakita sa imong tracking system diha, naapay mo depart, no? Naapay mo depart. So, tuyok-tuyok sa ka para dili para makalupad, samtang makalupad pa, wala pa kalupad ang isa ka airplane, no? Para dili mo mag-abot sa runway. So, ingana nga mga simple lang na analysis. And also for the precise positioning of marine mapping, exploration, and hydrography, of course, hydrography. Kay karon, no, so pag may yung tag-hydrography, determining the depth of the seas, oceans, rivers, no? So si sa eco sounder ang iyara makuha na is ang kalawamon lang, no, ang kalawamon sa isa ka tubig, no? Pero pag imo na siyang partneran o GNSS receiver, which is output of the science of geodesy, satellite geodesy, is may mo lang three-dimensional, no, na ni location plus na napun siya yung depth. Kaya para pag i-process nimo siya sa GIS or other processing software, naka-georeference na siya. So kung sa to yung location yung nakabutang sa GIS, maugid to ang exact location sa ground. No? in marine geology and geophysics. Next is the connection of control of tide gauges, no? Or kanang itawag na to, unification of height systems, no? Kung naatay the unification of geodetic control networks, napunta unification of tide gauges, no? Para na sila connections. So these are the example of tide gauges. So buhatan na siya network kay para makakuha tag data, access of data. Kung tintahay na asay nakuha aning depth at this instant mo. So nasay location, matagaan siya location na okay na ay high tide dito. For monitoring purposes, by the way. Motion shape purpose. And for related other related fields, no? There are applications, no? Apply na to si satellite geodesy. It's the position of velocity determination for geophysical observation such as gravimetric, magnetic, no? Seismic surveys, also at the sea and in the air. Next is the determination of ice motion and glaciology. Like for example, kung gusto nyo ay monitor ang glaciers or kanang ice motion, no? Kung nabay changes or wala. So, output of the satellite is of course mga satellite images, no? Na imo ang gusto i-process and i-analyze. Next is the determination of satellite orbits and tomography of the atmosphere such as the ionosphere and troposphere. Example, no? The glaciers. Changes in glaciers. Summer 2013, inga niya ang forma. Pero pag-abot ng summer 2014, nanay changes. Of course, this one, no? Motion of the glaciers at a specific area. Alright? So, I guess this ends the topic 1, part 3. Of the GE114 satellite geodesy. So if you have questions, you can ask me through our Facebook page or you can message me in the LMS also. So I hope this helps, this video lecture help you in understanding the satellite geodesy amidst of the COVID-19 pandemic. So I hope na ma-appreciate ninyo ang kaninga video lectures. Isang wala ko sa inyong atubangan karon to discuss this thing, so mas okay na to kung natas ako na ako sa inyong atubangan kaya para mas interactive lang ato ang discussion, but dili pa magiging siya feasible. So for now, panilang sa, no? I hope na ma-appreciate ninyo ang effort na gibuhat sa mga instructors karon, like this one, no? The video lectures para at least mag-guide ni gihapon mo nga moral na dyan sa inyong atubangan. So alright, so thank you so much for listening and keep safe everyone and have a good day.